Valley Forge and Bolt meter overview. This is SPC4 424A. We're going to talk about the 424A system. It's a system that allows any torque wrench to be controlled by the bolt. So the bolt will turn off the torquing method when the bolt sees the right load. So we can control pneumatics, electric, and hydraulic wrenches through this unit, okay? So what does this kit entail? You have the SPC4 24 meter, and again, it comes in a kit style, so you've got the cleaning brush here in this pocket. You've got a SPC4 a calibration gauge, and it was serial number 100 and 0 on it so that you can make sure that the meter is reading correctly. It's got a certificate for that, and it has the instructions. This gray box is an interface to allow you to connect to any electric hydraulic torque wrench. Most of the time, this is all that we use. Sometimes we add an air solenoid to control pneumatics. So, air over hydraulic, electric torque wrenches are controlled by this. This unit comes exactly like this. It's got your input-output cables for power with no ends on them because we know that different sites have different connections and it needs to be wired in for those sites. Comes in 110 or 220 volt. It's got a green lens or a green light and an orange amber light that shows you where it's at as far as power going to the meter. And we're going to display that and demonstrate that here shortly. So that's the gray box that connects it. It's got a circuit breaker on it right here that allows you to turn it on and off. You have to supply the cable ends to whatever you're connecting into your power source at your site. The cable plugs into the side of the unit right here, plugs in here, gets connected, and also plugs into the bottom of the unit. This is the only Valley Forge meter that is not powered by batteries, and it must be used with this gray box and this cable to get power. Okay? So, this one also, we put a straight connection point on it so that when you clip on, if you're torquing from the head, you get the advantage to be able to have the torque wrench go through or pass through an open cassette style torque wrench. What does that mean? I've got an open style cassette wrench. I put it on the head of the fastener, and then I can come in here and use it to torque from the head side of the bolt and control this unit. So pull it off, go to the next one, and then clip on so you can check load. So with that, I'll go into the demonstration of the SPC424. We've got a unit that is connected to a hydraulic, pneumatic, or electric torque wrench, or whatever muscle you want to use, as long as it's controllable through a signal. And we control that through an interface cable. We turn the unit on, and we program in what bolt load we want to see. So you can do that by attaching your calibration probe to the unit, reading zero, okay? And then when you bring your unit up, you hit the program button, and you program it up to whatever you want your stop point to be. Here's 65% bolt load. I'm going to go to actually 60% bolt load. I can go down to 55, I can take it to 35, I can stop that fastener wherever you want. So I'm going to take it all to 60% bolt load, and then we're going to do a test with the fastener. You can then hit the start stop button, and your torque wrench is now energized. All you have to do is have your hydraulic torque wrench, which we have right here, connect it in. We're going to connect to a bolt, see the bolt load. Currently this bolt is reading 52% bolt load. Now when I hit the start button, it's going to energize the torque wrench. It's now ready to go. It's at 52%, and now I can come in here and run this torque wrench. Thank you. Now the bolt just set the torque wrench off at 60% load. So your hydraulic torque wrench is being controlled by your fastener, taking the operator out of the equation. This is the SPC4 24A model. You can torque from either side. We put a straight probe on these so that if you're needing to torque from the head side of the fastener, you can come over and install your torque wrench. And then put the probe on and tighten it from the head side. You can tighten from the nut side, depending on your needs of your joint. So with that, it's 424A.